Hey everybody, I'm Justin Delosh of Lone Star Gun Rights, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Mossberg Shockwave. New for 2017 and with an MSRP of $455, the Mossberg 590 Shockwave is a 14-inch pump-action firearm that does not require any NFA paperwork. The gun comes packaged in a basic cardboard box with two decals, owner's manual, Mossberg branded gun lock, and a letter from the Department of Justice explaining the legalities of the gun. Because a brand new receiver is fitted at the factory with a pistol grip first instead of a shoulder stock, it's considered a pistol grip only firearm. If the overall length of that firearm with the pistol grip and barrel installed is greater than 26 inches, then the barrel can legally be shorter than 18 inches. In the case of the 14-inch barreled Mossberg 590 Shockwave, the Raptor Bird's Head grip gives the gun an overall length of 26.125 inches. That makes the Shockwave legally considered a firearm and not a shotgun. The gun features a hard anodized aluminum receiver, 14-inch matte blue steel barrel with brass bead sight, Shockwave Technologies Bird's Head grip, ambidextrous top-mounted safety, and a Shockwave Technologies Raptor strap forend. The fit, finish, and quality of the gun is good, and it feels solid in your hands. The Shockwave's capacity is 5+1 when loading 2¾-inch shells. When loading 3-inch shells, the capacity drops to 4+1. While shooting the gun, it was difficult for me to raise the gun to a level where the front bead sight was actually useful. This has to do with the angle of the bird's head grip and it being uncomfortable for me to bend my wrist much more than I was. This may vary and not be as much of an issue to someone else. Whether you're raising the gun up or shooting it from the hip, you're really not using the front sight to aim with. Despite this, I was still able to put many rounds on target at 7 yards. Being such a small gun, it does have quite a bit of kick, and with sweaty hands it can be difficult to hold onto. After shooting the gun, I'm convinced that the front strap is more for keeping the gun in your hand than it is keeping your hand away from the muzzle. We performed a trigger pull test on our Shockwave, and the 5-pull average was 4 pounds, 2.7 ounces. We had no complaints here. I had a lot of fun shooting the Shockwave, and it's definitely a lot of power in a small package. That being said, it was hard for me to really find the practicality in it. But if you're just looking for a gun that is a blast to shoot, this one fits the bill. We also really like to see firearm manufacturers push the limits of the NFA requirements, pointing out how ridiculous some of them are. Hopefully, someday we will no longer have these requirements. And that's all we have for today. We'd like to thank Central Texas Gunworks for supplying this gun for review. If you're in the Austin area, go check them out. They have a great selection and can order anything you need. If you liked this review, please give it a thumbs up and let us know in the comment section what you'd like to see us review next. If you have any questions about this review or the Shockwave, shoot us a message or leave it in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to follow us on Facebook at Lone Star Gun Rights. As always, Lone Star Gunners, stay armed, stay vigilant.